I'm going to present Rizal Without the Overcoat, a book originated from Philippines, written in English language, published by Anvil Publishing Incorporation on 1990 with 160 pages, winning a National Book Award for Essay and NBDB Book Award for Essay. These writings were attempts to translate Jose Rizal in his historical context so that he could be better understood by a new generation to present a new Rizal that had been obscured by school and myth. In 1999, an expanded edition of the book was published to which was added an award-winning series of commentary on Rizal which Ocampo had written, although it garnered immense popularity. The book uncovers the other side of the nationalistic icon. Dr. Jose Rizal, Mr. Ocampo has written down information concerning Rizal that is new to us, far out from the high school instruction given to us back then. Ocampo aims to let us know that our national hero is also an ordinary man like us. It may be thought that the author is an anti-Rizal, but then his real purpose is to reveal the truth and raise. The book does not intend to mislead us, but rather to give us facts and then allowing us to decide on what things to believe in. There is an overemphasis on the way the Philippine educational curriculum instills the idea about Rizal in the young minds of elementary and high school students. Others didn't bother to question themselves like what Ocampo did to himself. What would Rizal be like without his overcoat? He had written such with the thought that the analysis he was referring to in particular is the graphological analysis of the penmanship of Rizal and the other Philippine heroes. The interpretation on Rizal was graphologists described the man as nearly an ideal man who was courageous ambitions, influential personality, and self-sacrificing generosity. But look how Ocampo gave us a twist of supplementary information of how one's technique of attempting to translate one's graphological analysis could be very biased in a way that one would construct conclusions because he already has knowledge of the person before. Ambet Ocampo did not create a new result in his own view, but he just sustained us with what was a whole before. With sufficient supporting evidence at hand, it is apparent that he never narrowed down in giving us details. He did not simply fill us up with his ideas and insights, but he taught us to exercise our rights to choose of where to put our trust in, and from that we generate our own realizations. The most remarkable thing about the book is that it does not deprive us from knowing the possible truth about our national hero.
Ascendance of Chinese mestizos, Rizal's cultural roots. So first, we will be discussing Chinese history in the Philippines. In 1594, Spanish Governor Luis Perez das Mariñas created Binondo as a permanent settlement of the Chinese mestizos who converted to Catholicism. In Binondo, this part of Manila, Chinese merchants and traders were free to do their business. It also became the place of intermarriages between Chinese immigrants and Filipino natives, thus the emergence of Chinese mestizos. So there are communities where Chinese mestizos emerge aside from Binondo. First, Santa Cruz and Tondo, which is a part of Manila, Iloilo, Pampanga, Cebu, Pangasinan, Benguet, and Mountain Province, which is a part of Northern Luzon. Beginning of the Spanish colonial period until 1740, inhabitants of the Philippines were classified into three. These are Spaniards, Indios, and Chinese. In 1741, Chinese mestizo questioned their legal status as inhabitants, so it was officially established and the whole population of Philippines was classified into four according to tax payment or tribute. These are first, Spaniards and Spanish mestizos, second, Indios, third, Chinese, and fourth, Chinese mestizos. Spaniards and Spanish mestizos were not required to pay taxes according to their income. A Chinese mestizo then was any person born of a Chinese father and Indio mother, a Spanish mestiza and Chinese mestizo, a child of a Spanish mestiza and a Chinese mestizo. However, a Chinese mestiza and an Indio were listed as Indios.
Significance of Chinese mestizo. During the Spanish colonial period, Chinese mestizo became prominent and influential figures in the areas of industry, commerce, and business. The Chinese mestizos carried on a lucrative by collecting goods from the north and selling them to Manila and nearby provinces. They monopolized the internal trade in the Philippines, while the Spanish mestizos were concerned with foreign trade. The entrepreneurial power of the Chinese mestizos gave way to the emergence of the Philippine middle class, described as more active and enterprising, more prudent and pioneering, more oriented to trade and commerce than the Indios. Another significant role that Chinese mestizos played in the Philippine society was the formation of the Filipino identity. This was evident during the latter part of the 19th century, when they became clearly influential in the economy of the Philippines as the Spanish colony. This caused the Spaniards to be concerned with the ability of the Chinese mestizos to cause discord in society. In 1800, Chinese mestizos in the provinces began to form opinions regarding the Spanish colonial time rule. It was also difficult to separate the Indios from Chinese mestizos since they identified themselves with each other socially and culturally. The Chinese mestizos shared grievances with the Indios about the harsh conditions under the Spanish rule. And in the late 1870s, the most vivid manifestation of the budding sense of the Filipino nationalism appeared by the writing of Pedro Paterno and Gregorio Sanciano, who were both Chinese mestizos. The writings written by Paterno and Sanciano were nurtured by Jose Rizal, a non-pride of the Malay race but also a Chinese mestizo. The significant role of Chinese mestizos in the making of the nation was highly evident as the turn of the century.
Rizal and the Chinese mestizos. Jose Rizal is a fifth-generation Chinese mestizo, but he and his father were considered as Indios. Some documents and scholarly papers noted that he disliked being called Chinese mestizo or Chinoy in modern sense, and disassociated himself from any Chinese relations. Through his novel Noli Mi Tangere and El Filibusterismo, he exposed the abuses and corruption of Spanish authorities, condemned the oppression of the people by the colonizers, and ridiculed the hypocrisy and overbearing attitude of the Spanish friars. He is a nationalist and a Filipino. So that concludes our report. Thank you.